we were discussing what we could do with these objects. Right? So one of the things we said was a train could ask a station whether the platform is free. But in general, we could ask a station, I mean, not a train, but from our perspective also, we could ask the same thing to each station. We could say, do you have a train waiting at the platform at the moment or not? Right?
Each station you would ask.
Each station, yeah. Now, this is the point, right? So now we have to go through all the stations. So even if we have this idea of concurrency, right, we have to first ask the first station. Then we have to go back, ask the second station. So we have to call this some however many stations, 100 times we have to do this. And it's the same question.
Same question.
Same question. And we want the answer now. So the other
thing is, even worse than trains.
Yeah.
Because
no, but also the other problem, by the time I ask the 100th question, right, maybe some 2 minutes have passed. So maybe in that time, the information I got about the 100th train is not the same as the information I got about the first train. So it would be nice to be able to just send this, you know, at one
shot. All stations.
Yeah. We would just want to say.
I'm not saying to one station. I'm saying to all stations.
Yeah. So it's like you have a siren which goes off.
And I'm saying to all stations, like the circular you sent, like that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And everybody report
all
back.
Classrooms, you send one circular to every class.
Yeah.
Or put it in the notice board or something like that.
And then everybody has to report back their answer, right?
This is broadcasting.
Yeah. So we are broadcasting this question. We are not asking it to any specific station. Right? We are just putting it out as a message to everybody.
Crazy. Yeah? Procedure call means basically you will call an object procedure. No, it's not like that.
No. So this is, So this
you
is
just,
not,
You made a call. You made a general call, not to anybody.
Yeah, so you're asking for some information in this particular case, and the information is
anybody can answer it.
Everybody should answer it. Anybody also could answer it. So there could be two different ways of doing this, right? So in this case, we're asking every station to report whether or not it has.
So the broadcast just say whether you want to answer from everybody or from one person,
or you decide what you want to do with it, right? Uh-huh. So for instance, you might have a broadcast, right? Supposing you need something, right? So you. Say you have an emergency at home and you need to mop up some water.
Okay.
So you might send out a broadcast on your building WhatsApp group saying anybody have a suction mop, right? And if anybody says yes, you're happy. You don't expect everybody to have it.
One person is enough.
One person. Right? So here you broadcast it and you interpret the answer. So everybody tells you whether they have a train station, a train waiting in that station or not. You decide what you want to do with the information.
So this is some crazy thing, right? In a procedure call, even when we did remote procedure call with this producer consumer model, we gave it a tray, then that guy, specific tray for him, right?
Yeah.
Nobody else.
Yeah.
Physics teacher had his own tray, chemistry. And then the guy was supposed to put his result because that's otherwise you will not have any sanity, no?
Because you don't even know who these stations are now. In some sense, you are not addressing it to anyone.
So, if I broadcast something, first of all, the other guy should know that. These broadcasts are coming, so they should be looking somewhere for broadcast.
Correct.
Second is that they should know where to put the answer, no? There should be some agreed method of putting the answer back somewhere.
So maybe we could have a tray for this broadcast.
Firstly, there is a broadcast. So everybody knows that there are going to be broadcasts.
Yes.
So they keep there is a tray which they look for. Every station is looking in some tray to see whether or not there is a broadcast today.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah. That is one.
That's a notice board or whatever. Or you know, like in an email or an app, there's a notification. Right? You have a new message.
Your new message, something.
So then they have to go and look up that message.
They go look up the broadcast. They'll go up that. Yeah, they get a notification. They go look in the tray, broadcast tray. And if they find something sitting there,
they have to decide how to send the answer back. Yeah, that's what we are discussing. So
this is some shared place, I guess.
Yeah. So maybe I'm saying depending on who has sent the broadcast, each person who sends the broadcast has a single
shared tray
for everybody to put their answers.
Everybody will share that tray. Lot of concurrency problems. But everybody. So but then they have to say who they are, no? People and
they have to say because it's not useful to know that one person has a mop. You need to know who has the mop.
You have to know where to pick it up. So the guy will say, "Hey, I am station Adra, and I have a station train
waiting
number
right now.
Something waiting right now in me He has to say that. Yeah. So he has to identify himself and
the
answer, and he will put it in the tray.
In this answer,
the common tray.
Yeah, this answer tray.
It's not a chemistry tray, physics tray, maths tray.
Yeah.
It's one tray. That's all.
And
single
it can
tray.
It can hold a lot of information, because every station potentially
will try to write into it.
Yeah. So of course we have the old problem of reading and writing concurrency. So we will assume that this, so we have one common answer tray, right?
One tray only. Broadcast answer tray. Yeah. Everybody tried to write into it.
Everybody is trying to write into it. Right? And we had this old problem that we must have atomic.
It should be atomic. Only one guy can write at a time and one read only at a time.
Right.
Oh, okay. Two people can't write at the same time. That will be a huge problem otherwise. Huh?
Yeah. So both read and write from this. So the broadcaster will look for the answer there.
Hmm.
And when it's looking for the answer, nobody should be writing an answer.
Hmm.
And when somebody is writing an answer, nobody else should be writing an answer, and nobody should be reading an answer.
And he'll wait for some time, keep collecting answers. After some time, he'll time out and say, okay, I think I've got enough responses.
Yeah.
He can process it, right?
Correct. So supposing he's waiting for five answers, so then, right? So then you can decide. So
he'll wait for 5 minutes or 10 minutes, something.
Yeah.
And then after that, he will see whatever answers are there. Accordingly, he will make a decision.
Yeah.
These are the train stations where the trains are waiting.
Yes.
This is cool, because this way, broadcast nice, because this way I don't need to tell each station.
Correct.
One by one.
Mm.
Right? One message I send, that's all.
Yeah. And whoever is there will get the message. That's it.
And then they will respond in a common place, and then done.
Mm.
Very nice. But in the case of trains, it's tougher, no? Because station is always there.
Correct. So trains have different lifetimes, right? Yes. So when you send a broadcast at a particular time.
Suppose I want to ask the train. Are you running? Yeah, are you running?
So some of them will say yes, and the others won't respond because they are not running. Or will they? I mean, do these objects, are they always running?
They're not there, no?
Yeah, because they are not.
The object isn't even there.
Yeah. Yeah, it gets.
So you have possible situation that so if you don't get anything for some trains, you don't get any answer at all.
Hmm.
Means the object is not there. One assumes. But if the train is alive, which means it's running. Elements, the object has been created, then it should respond either yes, I am running, or it should say no, I am not running.
Yeah.
Something like that it should say, right?
Yeah.
It can't just say yes, I am running, and if it's no, you keep quiet, because if you keep quiet, then
you don't know if the object has been created or not. Yes. So that we have to assume, therefore, this broadcast will actually reach every object which is created.
Alive.
Which is currently exists.
Exists.
And they will all give an answer.
Give an answer. They will either say, yes, I am running, or no, I am at rest, I am stopped, right, at this point in time.
Yeah.
And so you will get an answer. So if you look at your tray, input tray now, after the broadcast, you will see number of trains have responded.
Mm.
These are the trains which are?
Alive.
Alive. Have been created. Mm. Some of them will say, yes, I am running. Some of them will say, no, I am not running.
Mm.
So you will know the answer. But this is cool. This method is much better than. Otherwise, what I have to do? Firstly, I don't even know which are the trains.
Yeah, so you don't
know. How do I call them?
Yeah, because
you don't
have
even
to
know
you
they
have
are.
To address a procedure to each object. First, you have to determine whether the object. So this is kind of indirectly telling you which ones are there.
If I want to do otherwise, I have to ask each class. I have to go to the class train classes.
Yeah,
and say, hey, which are the objects you created?
Yeah.
Then he'll give me some objects. Mm. Then I have to call each of those objects and say, hey, are you running?
Mm.
Such a painful thing, right?
Mm.
I can just broadcast. Broadcast is so much better.
Mm. Mm.